But this woman, she pressed away. She pressed away. She pressed away with understanding.
Amen.
Knowing.
That's right.
She pressed away with understanding and knowledge, knowing.
Yeah.
That in the Old Testament, that the priests had a certain garment. Oh God, and the tassels is to the bottom of the garment.
Amen.
And the tassels, it was the law of God.
Right.
This woman understood that. So this woman had to be an Israelite because she understood the law. She understood it.
Amen.
And I believe that this woman peeped in Malachi. And hear what Malachi says, the Son of Man shall come and healing shall be in his wing.
Yes.
So the woman built up her faith to herself, telling herself that I'm going to be healed.
Amen.
You have to tell yourself you're going to be healed before it even happen.
Amen.
You have to tell. See, this woman made a before she go publicly, before she pressed her way to Jesus, she made a firm confession with herself. She tell herself. She strengthened herself. She builds up her faith in herself by saying, if I can only touch the hem of his garment, I know I will be made whole. I know that I will be made whole. The enemy doesn't want you to touch Jesus. The enemy doesn't want you to touch Jesus. He doesn't want you. He wants you to continue in religion. And religion can't save you. Religion can't bring healing. Religion can't bring deliverance. But only Jesus can do it. I says only Jesus can bring deliverance. And only Jesus can bring healing. Do you believe that God is the same yesterday and today and forever?
Amen.
I said, do you believe that God is the same today?
Amen.
Yesterday, today, and forever?
Amen.
In spite of what you are facing today, do you believe he's still the same?
Amen.
If you believe he is the same, I come to you. I come to you. I come. Help you to build up your faith to receive.
Amen.
To receive from God. To receive from God.
Amen.
We know that the word of God, according to the book of Psalms 119, he says, O Lord, thy word has settled in heaven forever. So the word of God is what? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
It is finished.
Amen.
I really don't think you all understand what you all just tell your neighbor.
It's finished. Everything finished.
I really don't think you really understand what you just told your neighbor. When something is finished, it takes away the worrying about it.
Amen.
It takes the way of caring for things because it is finished.
That's right.
And when something is established forever, it means it's unchangeable.
Amen.
The word of God is unchangeable. You can't reverse this word because it liveth and abideth forever. God is in bondage to nothing but his word. Because his words is him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now watch. Turn the Bible to Matthew, the 8th chapter, in the 16th and the 17th verse. Matthew chapter 8 in verse 16 and 17. Matthew chapter 8 in verse 16 and 17. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory be to God. Sometimes you just need to laugh. I'm telling you, sometimes you just need to laugh.
Amen.
Ah, when people ask you what you laugh for, the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Amen.
Glory be to God, because it is finished. Let's laugh. When the devil knows that you are going through a storm and you're laughing, he knows you have confidence.
Amen.
That this storm will not last forever.
Amen.
That's why you can laugh about it.
Amen.
Some folks is crying about it, but you laughing about it. Because you know and understand the end result of this storm. You know it. You know it, and you understand the end result of the storm, so you can laugh about it. Amen. Amen. In the Bahamas, they will tell you, like, when you don't laugh, in the Bahamas will tell you, stop being uptight. See, when it's so uptight. See, if the whole world dying in you. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, let's read from the verse 16. Missionary, verse 16. Can I teach a little bit and then I can, then whatever the will of the Spirit of God is going to happen. Matthew, the 8th chapter, and the 16 and 17 verse. If you haven't, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Go ahead. Verse 16.
When the evening must come.
When the evening was come.
They brought unto him many that were possessed.
They brought unto Jesus many people who was possessed by devils. Amen. So a lot of sickness is because of demons. Read.
And he cast out the spirits with his words.
Okay. I want you to underline this. And he cast out the spirits with his word. I say, he cast out the spirits with his word. This is the topic. The word of God have power to heal you. The word of God have power to heal you.
Amen.
Amen. He cast out it by what?
His word.
His word. So there is a what? There is an authority that is in the word of God when you speak it. When you act upon the word of God, God will. He will perform that. Why? Because that's his word.
And heal all that were sick.
And heal every person that was sick. Heal everybody that was sick. And the key words, by his words. Don't forget that. By his word. Without the word of God, there can be no healing. Read.
And it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took all infirmities.
Himself take what? So Jesus took your infirmity. What you doing talking about my high blood pressure? What you doing talking about my sugar diabetes? What you doing talking about my cancer? Why are you owning it when Jesus then take all of our infirmities? When you sense my high blood pressure, you'll never be healed from high blood pressure. When you sense my sugar diabetes, you will never be healed from sugar diabetes.